So in this session, we are going to learn how to install Grafana on a Linux machine. So in this session, I am taking a reference of my article, which I have written on itpanther.com. And if you want to see all the articles written about Grafana, you can log into this website, itpanther.com, and then come to Grafana section. And once you do that, you should be able to see all the articles which is written about Grafana. Okay, so here you can go to installing Grafana on Windows or on Linux, and then you can click on read more, and then you will be able to come to the same page which I'm using. Okay, so I'll close one tab and let one tab open. Okay, so what we need to know before installing Grafana on Linux. Okay, so one important thing which we need to know is that Grafana needs one database to keep its application related database. Okay, so by default Grafana uses SQLite. Okay, that is the database which is embedded in this software. So what that means is that when you are downloading Grafana and installing Grafana, you don't need to download and install SQLite separately. It just gets installed when you install Grafana. However, let's say for some reason you don't want to use SQLite, you want to use any additional database which can be MySQL or PostgreSQL. In that case, there are some additional configuration is required. So we will do those things in upcoming sessions. In this session, we are just going to stick to installing Grafana in a default mode, and that's why it is just going to use SQLite. Now, once you install Grafana, you access Grafana using a web interface. So basically, it is you are going to need a browser in order to access Grafana. Okay, so the browser which can be used is Chrome, Firefox, Safari, or Microsoft Edge. So it supports all the modern browsers. Okay, so whenever we are using any web-based application, there are two things comes into picture. One is the URL and the other thing is the port. Okay, so Grafana by default uses 3000 port. Most of the web application when you run it uses port 80 or 8080, something like that. Grafana uses 3000. So there is a good chance that if you install Grafana on the server where other web applications are also installed, it is not going to clash with your other web application because they are running on a different port and this is going to run on a different port. However, it is your job to ensure that you are not using this port already before installing Grafana. If you are doing that, then you need to make sure that you change the port of Grafana before starting Grafana services. Okay, so we will see those things later. Now, depending on the Linux or Unix flavor you are on, you can choose which command you want to use to install. So in this case, since I'm on CentOS, I'm going to use these commands. Okay, so now let's go to the server. I already have a server and I'm logged in as Grafana admin user, and my current working directory is /home/grafana-admin, and hostname of this server is itpanther02. And if I do ls, you can see right now I do not have anything stored here. Okay, so we are into /home/grafana-admin, and this is a blank directory, there is nothing there. Okay, so now let's begin by copy pasting this command. And now what this command basically does is it is going to download this RPM from dl.grafana.com website. Okay, and if you are on Unix or Linux system, you already know that wget is the utility which you use to download anything, okay, on a Linux system. So I will use wget, hit enter, and let's see what happens. Oops, as you can see, for some reason we are getting the error. So basically what has happened here is we do not have wget already installed. Okay, so if you are in the same situation like me, you are also probably going to get the error. some similar error. And now the thing which you need to do is you need to install wget. So for that we are going to do sudo yum-y install wget. Okay, so this is the command to install wget and it is pretty simple. So if you do not have wget, use this command, hit enter, and it is going to install wget. So once that is done, I'm going to clear the screen and then I'm going to run the same command which we were trying previously. Okay, so wget followed with the rpm URL. Hit enter. This time you see downloading has started and we were able to download rpm file with 68.1 MB in size. Okay, so if I do ls-lrt, this time you can see now we have Grafana rpm already on our server. So now I'm going to go back and I'm going to see the second command, which is sudo yum install, and we need to give path of the rpm. So here we need to copy paste the same thing, and just make sure if you have downloaded any other version of Grafana, just make sure when you are installing it you give the same name. So what you can do is you can just remove whatever is here and you just need to make sure whatever you have downloaded, the same thing is copy pasted here. Now hit enter and it is going to install Grafana. Okay, now here it is asking for confirmation, so you can press Y to continue installing Grafana. And now you see some success message saying that Grafana is successfully installed and it is completed. Okay, now you see some messages here. Okay, so basically what it is saying is not starting on installation. So what it means is that by default it has installed Grafana but it has not started Grafana services. Okay, so now how do you verify whether Grafana is started or not, or whether it is running or not? Now the way to do that is you can use sudo systemctl and you can use status, and then you need to type this grafana-server.service. Okay, hit enter and here you can see the status that Grafana is inactive. So when you install Grafana, by default it is in deactive mode. Okay, now what do you do when you need to start Grafana? Okay, so you use the same command. Let me clear the screen first. So I'll press Ctrl C and then next line I will type clear, hit enter, and here we will basically type the same command which we used for status, and then we are going to change status to start. Okay, and then if I hit enter now, I'll be able to, you know, start Grafana. But before we even do that, I'm going to press Ctrl C again to cancel this command. I have not run this command yet. Now the other way basically to check if Grafana is already running or not is using telnet command. So telnet command is going to tell you whether you are able to listen on a particular, you know, port. So if I do, now we know that Grafana runs on port 3000. So if I do telnet localhost 3000, basically it should be able to telnet. So it should be able to connect. Okay, and please note you will only be able to run this command if you have telnet installed. Okay, so if you do not have telnet installed, it is probably going to give you some similar error which you got in case of wget. So let's hit enter and we see we are getting the similar error which we got in case of wget. So as we know, the next thing which we need to do is we need to install telnet using sudo space yum space hyphen y install telnet. Hit enter, should take couple of minutes and should install telnet. So now we see telnet is successfully installed. I'm going to clear the screen and let's run telnet localhost 3000 again. Hit enter. We see we are getting error saying connection refused. Okay, so what it means is there is no service which is listening on port 3000. So that's other way of checking whether Grafana is running or not. Okay, so if you are troubleshooting or if you want to make sure that Grafana is running on any server or not, you can use this command. And if your Grafana is running on a remote server, so rather than localhost, here you need to provide the actual IP address of the server, so something like this. Okay, this is how you check whether port 3000 is listening or not. Alright, so let's clear the screen, and this time we are going to start Grafana by using sudo systemctl start command. And make sure you type grafana-server.service, hit enter, and it is going to start Grafana. So you have not got any message in return, you just run this command and it makes your prompt change to the next line. And now if you want to see the status, you need to use status command again. Hit enter, and now you see it is showing it is active. So that is how you know that Grafana is running. Now let's run that telnet command again and let's see what happens this time. So now if I do telnet space localhost space 3000, hit enter, this time you see we are getting the message that connected to localhost, which means there is some service which is listening on this port, and we know that service is Grafana service. Okay, so I'm going to press Ctrl C to escape. And now we can clear the screen. Okay, so now we know Grafana is going to run on the URL which is going to be your server hostname followed by port 3000. Okay, so if you do not have DNS, then probably you need to use IP address. In my case, I need to use IP address. So this is the IP address of this server. And I'm going to open a new tab. I will type the IP address followed with the port which is 3000, hit enter, and you should be able to see Grafana launching. If you do not see Grafana launching, it means for some reason installation was not successful and you need to further troubleshoot what went wrong with Grafana. Okay, now you see it is prompting us with email and password. Now if you remember, we haven't really set up any email or password when we installed Grafana. Okay, so what we need to do is there is a default username and password which we need to use. So that default username and password is admin admin. Okay, so let's type admin, password also going to be admin, hit enter, and now we see it is saying we are logged in, also giving us prompt to change the password. Okay, so I'm going to change the password. If you want to skip this step, you can use skip, but it is always a good practice after installing Grafana, change the password, because as you know, anyone who is aware about Grafana, they'll be knowing that default username and password is admin admin, and they may try to, you know, use default admin credential and will be able to log into Grafana if you haven't changed the username and password. Okay, so basically the password which you should be changing. And click on save. Now you see you are going to go to the screen of Grafana. Okay, that's how Grafana looks like when you install Grafana and access Grafana for the first time. Now I'm going back to my article. So here I have also written how you can manage the services, which is basically how you start, stop, or check the status of Grafana services. Okay, so let's say if I want to stop Grafana, so what I need to do is, it is going to be the same command which you used for checking status or starting, and the only thing which you can change here is this keyword. So you change it to stop Grafana. Hit enter, and now Grafana is stopped. How do you verify? Now to verify, you can use status. Hit enter, here you should see the status is set to inactive. The other thing is when I go here, if I refresh, I should not be able to see this page. Okay, so I have refreshed. It is trying to connect and it is basically giving us error saying site cannot be reached, because we know we have stopped Grafana services. Okay, I'm going to start it one more time. And let's go back to this website of Grafana. Okay, and hit refresh. Now we see we are able to log into Grafana again. Now let's say for some reason you want to uninstall Grafana. So the step for that is, if you have Grafana already running, first thing probably a good advice is you stop Grafana. So now if I refresh, I'll not be able to access this, you know, Grafana page, and it is going to give us an error. Now if you want to uninstall Grafana, we need to use this command. Okay, so sudo yum remove. So let me clear the screen first. Let me do ls-lrt. So if you remember, this is the RPM which we had downloaded. So we need to use sudo space yum space remove space the RPM which we have downloaded, and here we need to take out .rpm. Okay, so just take out .rpm and leave the remaining part. Hit enter and it is going to uninstall Grafana. Okay, so I'm going to hit enter and it is going to make sure that Grafana is uninstalled. It is asking for confirmation. I'm going to give Y for confirmation. Now you see it has uninstalled Grafana. Now if you run command of checking status, it is basically going to give you error because there is no service named grafana-server.service is running, or your operating system cannot recognize anything like this. Okay, because Grafana is totally uninstalled from this server. So that's it in this session. Just to summarize, in this session we have learned about Grafana prerequisites like database, and we also know what are the supported web browsers. Then we learned that by default it works on port 3000, and also we followed the steps to install on CentOS, and then we went on logged into the Grafana by using admin credential, which is the default one. We also changed the password, and then we learned on how to stop or check the status of Grafana service, and then we also went on to uninstall Grafana. So in your environment, if you don't want to uninstall, just skip this step and follow on the remaining steps.